This episode of Construct Tech TV is brought to you by Jamf Now.
As always, human capital metrics are often collected by companies, but all too often they are not typically reported. A new report sheds some light on human capital metrics and how it impacts safety in construction. Joining me today to give us a little more insight into all of this is Carl Heinlein, who is the Senior Safety Consultant at the American Contractors Insurance Group and Director at Large for the American Society of Safety Engineers. Carl, welcome.
Good afternoon.
So, Carl, let's talk about this. It's really important when we think about what the ASSSE kind of funded a study, if I'm understanding right, with the Harvard Law School. What does that really mean, and what did you guys do there?
Great. Well, what we did was we worked with Harvard to take a look at human capital and how it worked with the occupational safety and health field. And what we found after we did research with about 2,000 global companies from around the world, that a lot of the information's out there, but it's being held by the companies and it's not publicly available. And why that's important is we want to make sure that we have the ability to benchmark these best practices and these metrics against each other, ultimately to improve job site safety, job site production, job site quality.
You and I both know safety is of the utmost importance. What were some of the major outcomes of this study that you discovered that maybe most people might not understand right now?
Well, what we found is around the world that Europe and Asia lead with gathering the metrics, first of all.
Well, let me interrupt. That's disturbing right there. If you tell me other countries are leading us,
yes.
I find that problematic right there.
Well, they're gathering information a lot more aggressively than we are. And the information that we're gathering is inconsistent, and it's not really one of the biggest issues. It's not shared. So if we can't learn about it, we can't improve.
Well, data, gathering information, we know. We talk about data, data, data all the time.
Yes.
Why aren't we doing that at our job sites?
Well, I think we're doing a good job in the construction world at the job sites, but what's happening is we're not sharing that information across the board. We're not sharing our best practices and learning from each other. Certainly, at the international level, as well as in the United States. So there's opportunity there.
Now that's surprising to me because construction is an industry that, unlike others, are very forthright in sharing information. Why are we not sharing this kind of information when we could, especially about safety and metrics like that, when that's foremost, as I mentioned, amongst everything when we think about safety?
Well, I think we do a good job of sharing some information, but I just don't think it's some cases the correct information, the detailed information, really the lessons learned where we can improve at. And that's an area when we went through the study, we found that some people were collecting some information, some companies are collecting other information. So there's consistency of what the information is available out there. So typically what people share may be OSHA related data, Occupational Safety and Health Administration. That's good, but that's really lagging information. We're trying to find out other indicators that are leading indicators that may be much more beneficial for companies and really produce better results.
How do we get them to share this key information? Because I think those metrics can help us improve so that we have less injuries, less deaths at the job site, construction, globally. I think that's what we want because we really are a very small world. We
sure.
think we're big, but we're really a
You're
small
right.
world.
Correct. And we also have a lot of small employers. So how do we impact the small employers? How do we get a better job of creating that consistency in the information? And really, I think that there has to be some sort of standardized or, you know, a group of metrics, 12, 10, 15. There's a number of organizations around the world that some have 140, some have 30, some have 12. So I think it's the consistency of that information that really adds the value. What is important? So I think that one of the things that we found in the study is bringing a group of the experts together to say, what can we do better moving forward that we are getting consistent information?
Are we finding that the larger organizations do it better than the smaller? Is there some difference in the metrics that you discovered in that?
We do. In fact, the percentages are showing that the larger organizations, in some cases 97% of them, when they are reporting that information, it's much better value, much clearer, much more consistency within that. When you start to get to smaller organizations, you're not finding that consistency. They may not have the resources, they may not have the funding, they may not even know what they're looking for.
Is some of it a fear of sharing information? They don't want to share what they're doing because they don't want others to know they haven't done it well enough or they could be doing it better? Is some of that maybe some of the reluctance?
Great question. I think in some cases there may be that competitive advantage. I think in some cases it maybe they don't know what they don't know. So there's some breakdown in the communication. There's a trust issue. I think that there's a communication issue. And I think there's an understanding issue. So I think there's multiple steps within there about that communication. But there is hope. There's opportunity ahead that we can certainly, and I think it, what we found in this study is once you share this information, I think people are finding opportunities for better practices to improve ultimately their construction firms.
So where do we go from here, Carl? I mean, I always like to have my guests tell me the best things.
Sure.
We've learned what we're not doing, but where do we go from here to improve on our practices?
Well, I think that one thing is continued communication. And I think that the study, the one thing that it offers to us, and you can see that study at asse.org, to take a look at that and see what some of the findings are. We took a look at 12 metrics that we think that would be consistent for all organizations in the construction industry to take a look at and benchmark against. But again, we want to continue the conversation. We are currently right now in conversations about having another workshop with these industry experts to find out how we can continue. But we've got to continue the communication. We've got to continue that opportunity for people to share those best practices. So we still have work to do.
Well, Carl, it was great having you on the show. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Carl Heinlein, he's with the American Society of Safety Engineers. Thank you for joining us. That's all the time we have for this segment of Safety Zone. And remember, once more, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to Construct Tech TV channel on YouTube. So that's our issue and segment of Safety Zone for today.
Jamf now helps businesses manage Apple devices in the workplace. Jamf now makes managing and securing every work iPhone, iPad, and Mac easier than ever. See the power of Jamf now for yourself. Create an account today at jamf.com/constructtech. Start managing your first three devices for free. That's jamf.com/constructtech.